in acceleration, we have to discuss the uniform acceleration, non-uniform acceleration, position time graph and velocity time graph. And after this, we will get kinematics equation of motion. First, in earlier classes, that is in class 9, we have learnt about acceleration. What is acceleration? The time rate of change of velocity of a particle is acceleration. So, average acceleration will be del V by del T, means V2 minus V1 by T2 minus T1. Since here we are using velocity, so here the vector notation. Or we can say A average equal to del V by del T. Now the instantaneous acceleration. Acceleration of a particle at any instant. If a particle is moving and we want its acceleration at any instant, let velocity time or a particle Vt is like this and we want to hear the acceleration at this point, then at this point acceleration is called the instantaneous acceleration. And it is instantaneous acceleration, we say A vector equal to limit del T tends to 0 del V by del T or this is dV by dt. So it is the instantaneous acceleration, while average acceleration is del V by del T simply. So here that is instantaneous acceleration is dV by dt. And see the velocity is, earlier we have seen velocity is, it is ds by dt. So what is this? We can write this one as dv by dt into ds by dt. So it is d square s by dt square. Remember, it is not the d square as the simple algebra or in simple math. It is the second order derivative. So second order derivative of displacement gives acceleration. First order derivative of displacement gives velocity. First order derivative of velocity gives acceleration. Now here are certain points we should know or keep in mind. Acceleration is a vector quantity. The direction of acceleration here the direction of velocity is along the tangential at this point. So the direction of acceleration is same as the direction of velocity. As we have discussed earlier, velocity can be positive, zero or negative, because displacement can be positive, zero, negative. So that we can say acceleration can be either positive, zero or negative. If a body is moving with uniform velocity, means velocity is not changing at all, means in direction or in magnitude, then acceleration is zero. Acceleration, now it's a unit in CGS system, its unit is centimeter per second square, while in SI system meter per second square, or practically we can say kilometer per hour square. Now see the uniform acceleration, how we can define it. Uniform acceleration, if equal change of velocity in equal interval of time, then the body is said to be uniform acceleration. Here see, velocity changes at a uniform rate. In a simple way we can define, if velocity changes at uniform rate, then acceleration is uniform acceleration. See an example, that is motion of free falling body. Let at the top a ball is kept. If that base is removed, See, the at the time of falling, the ball fall freely. Another is example here, see, the sliding block. A block is kept on a slider. Now see, it's this motion, while it is sliding, its motion is uniform. While it was falling, its motion acceleration is g, and on the sliding, acceleration is downward. So, and because here in this direction it is moving, so, and it is the g direction, so we can, this angle is theta, so we can resolve it. This angle is theta, it is g cos theta, and this one is g sin theta. So it slides like that. So uniform acceleration. Now non-uniform acceleration. If velocity increases or decreases by unequal amounts in equal interval of time, or if velocity changes at a non-uniform rate. For example, see the motion of a car on a crowded city road. The speed, so that its velocity changes continuously. Here, see a car. See here, it decreases, then increases. Such acceleration is non-uniform acceleration. Now the retardation or deceleration or negative acceleration. If velocity decreases with time, then acceleration is said to be negative acceleration or retardation or deceleration. A car decelerating to come at halt. See here. So to stop a car, moving car, we have to apply brake. So by applying the brake, what we are doing? We are decreasing its velocity with respect to time. So it is a retardation. Now some graph. First the position time graph under the acceleration. And acceleration can be uniformly accelerated, that is positive acceleration first, see. It is the position along the y-axis and time is along x-axis. So see the positive acceleration. You will find it is the hyperbolic form. Because later on we will see why it is. See, it is the second order derivative of the displacement. Or if you see, remember, s equal to ut plus half at square. So that is, s is of one order and time of second degree. So its graph will be a hyperbolic or parabolic, we can say. Now negative acceleration, but uniform. See here, at this point we can see it is decreasing. So it is the uniformly decelerated or negative acceleration. Now the zero acceleration for that position time graph. It is a straight line because acceleration is zero. And if you remember the equation, s equal to ut plus half at square. And if acceleration is zero, see the position and time, both are of 1 degree. So the straight line. But if accelerated, it is the 2 degree and this is of the first degree. So the equation is parabolic. So it is the position time graph. Now the velocity time graph. If we see the velocity and acceleration, it is the first order. So velocity time graph, here see, the velocity increases. So it is the positive acceleration and a straight line. So motion is in positive direction with the positive acceleration. Now here see, what we are can say. Again it is, the velocity is along the positive direction. So though motion is in the positive direction, but acceleration is negative. Because upward of the origin we used to take positive. So body is moving in the positive direction, but with the retarding acceleration or negative acceleration. Another see here. Now the velocity is in the negative direction. How we can say? If we are here and if we consider right to me is the positive, then left to me will be negative. So here the negative, but acceleration is negative acceleration. Another here, see, motion with the, what we can say here? First see, the motion is along the positive direction up to certain extent and acceleration decreasing. So negative acceleration. But here we can say, motion is along the negative direction but acceleration increasing. One example we can say, if we fall this pen, if we throw it, its velocity decreases. At the going some height it will stop and then it will come down. So what will be that? See, if we plot the velocity time graph, where see an object is thrown up and velocity time graph for the an object is thrown up and then comes down. So first we are here, this pen is here and we are throwing it upward. So here, from here, its velocity will decrease. We have to throw some higher speed. So let it be, we are throwing with certain speed here, the V velocity. Then after some time, its velocity will zero. Means this is the position at the top where velocity becomes zero. And again what happened? It comes down. Comes down means accelerated. So its graph is this one. It is the velocity time graph. But what will be its speed time graph? It is the speed time graph of the same phenomenon. What happens? Here, this is speed C. Here we have to give certain velocity V. Then this body go up to certain height and then its velocity decreases. And is for the speed, no question of the direction. And again attaining at time t, attaining the zero speed, again that will come down with the increasing speed. So its graph will be this one. So it is the speed time graph of the, what's the example? An object is thrown up like this one and it comes down. So here after reaching, its velocity becomes zero. Then it starts increasing. Got the point? Now, we will take some questions.